Good morning students, welcome you all for Next Generation Learning. Today we are going to see the subject physics, class 10. Chapter number 13, Magnetic Effect of Electric Current. Topics. First topic, force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. Second topic, activity. Third topic, Fleming's left hand rule. At the last topic, application. The first topic, force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. What is the meaning of this topic? When a current carrying conductor is placed between the magnetic field, it experiences a force. So look at this circuit diagram. Here the conductor is connected to the battery and key. When the key is closed, the circuit is a closed circuit, so the current is started to flow. When an electric current flowing through a conductor, it produces a magnetic field around it. So when we place the magnetic compass near to the conductor, the magnetic field exerts some force on the magnetic compass needle. Due to that, the magnetic needle gets deflected. So French scientist André Marie Ampère suggested that magnet must also exert an equal and opposite force on the current carrying conductor. Here, the magnetic field produced around the current carrying conductor exert some force on the magnetic compass. The magnetic compass needle is also one of the small magnet. This magnet also exert some force on the current carrying conductor, but in opposite direction to this force. So before going to see the activity, you have to know the horseshoe magnet. See, this is a bar magnet, this is a horseshoe magnet. The bar magnet has two poles, one is north and another one is south. The same as the horseshoe magnet also has two poles, one is north and another one is south. And the direction of the magnetic field around a bar magnet is north to south. The same as if you take a horseshoe magnet, the magnetic field directions are north to south. It emerges from the north and merges at the south. So see the magnetic field direction. It emerges from the north and merges at the south. Activity. For doing this activity, you have to take aluminium rod, battery, wire, horseshoe magnet and stand. Take a small aluminium rod of length 5 cm. Using connecting wires, this is a connecting wires, using a connecting wires, suspend it horizontally from a stand. And place a horseshoe magnet in such a way that the rod lies between the two poles of the magnet. The north pole of the magnet vertically below. See here. Here the north pole of the magnet is vertically below. And the south pole of the magnet is vertically above the aluminium rod. Do you understand? You have to take an aluminium rod of length 5 cm and it is connected to wires suspended horizontally, and you have to place a horseshoe magnet. The north pole of the horseshoe magnet is vertically below and the south pole of the horseshoe magnet is vertically above the aluminium rod. Connect the aluminium rod in series with the battery, key and rheostat. Now see, the positive terminal of the battery is this side and negative is this side. So the direction of the current is always from positive to negative. Now close the key, the current is started to flow in the circuit. So the current is started to flow in the aluminium rod to from B end to A end. So what do you observe? When the current is flowing in the aluminium rod, what do you observe? Here the aluminium rod is act as a conductor. So when the current is flowing in the conductor, it produces a magnetic field around it. And here we have the external magnetic field from the horseshoe magnet. So what do you observe? It is observed that the rod is displaced towards the left. You will notice that rod get displaced. Why the rod get displaced? See, it was clearly shown in this image, the rod get displaced. Now reverse the direction of the current. See, the positive terminal is this side and negative terminal is this side. So the direction of the current is from A to B. So if you reverse the direction of the current is flowing in the aluminium rod is A to B. And observe the direction of the displacement. You have to observe the displacement. It is now towards the right. So see in these two images. Here the current direction is B to A. Here the current direction is A to B. When the current is flowing B to A, the rod get displaced to the left. Here the rod get displaced to the right. So from this we can say that the force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field, the direction of the force is reversed when the direction of the current through the conductor is reversed. When we change the direction of the current, the direction of the force of the conductor also changed. That means here the magnet have the field around it, and when the current is flowing in the conductor, it also gives the magnetic field. These two magnetic field or exert the force to each other. Due to that force, the conductor get displaced. Now change the direction of the field to vertically downward by interchanging the two poles of the magnet. In the first case, the north pole of the horseshoe magnet is below the rod and the south pole of the horseshoe magnet is above the rod. Now you have to interchange the pole. That means south is vertically down and north is vertically above the rod. It is once again observed that the direction of force acting on the current carrying rod get reversed. But here I am not changed the direction of the current. I just changed the pole of the horseshoe magnet. When we change the pole of the horseshoe magnet, the displacement of the rod also changed. In first case, see, the displacement is left. In second case, the displacement is right. So from this we can say that the direction of the force is reversed when the direction of the magnetic field is reversed. If you change the magnetic field direction, the direction of the force also changed. So conclusion, it shows that the direction of the force on the conductor depends upon the direction of the current and the direction of the magnetic field. If you change the direction of the current, the direction of the force on the conductor also changed. Think and you have to answer, why we take an aluminium rod for doing this experiment? Why we take an horseshoe magnet for doing this experiment? What is the meaning of this statement, force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field? I will tell you the answer. Why we take the aluminium rod for doing this experiment? Normally the aluminium rod does not attract to the magnet. But when the current is flowing through a aluminium rod, it produces a magnetic field. So this magnetic field attracts the magnet. Due to that, this aluminium rod gets displaced. So we chosen the aluminium rod for doing this experiment. Why we taken horseshoe magnet for doing this experiment? We need for the external magnetic field, so we chosen the horseshoe magnet. What is the meaning of this statement, force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field? When a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it experiences a force. Due to that force, the conductor can displaced. An experiment have shown that the displacement of the rod is the largest when the direction of the current is right angle to the direction of the magnetic field. When the magnetic field direction is right angle to the current direction, then the displacement of the rod is largest. I will explain you what is the meaning of this. In a such a condition, we can use a simple rule to find the direction of the force on the conductor. Look at this diagram. Here we know the direction of the current. Here the direction of the current is B to A. And the direction of the magnetic field is north to south. For in second diagram, the direction of the current is A to B. The direction of the magnetic field is north to south. But we don't know the direction of the displacement of the rod. Here the direction of the displacement of the rod is left. Here the direction of the displacement of the rod is right. So how to find the direction of the displacement of the rod? Using Fleming left hand rule, we can easily say the direction of the force on the conductor. For Fleming left hand rule is used to find the direction or force on the current carrying conductor. You have to take your right hand, left hand. According to this rule, stretch thumb, forefinger and middle finger of your left hand such that they are mutually perpendicular. The three fingers you have to kept mutually perpendicular to each other. That means the thumb and forefinger are mutually perpendicular, the same as the middle finger and forefinger are mutually perpendicular. You have to stretch the thumb, forefinger, middle finger of your left hand they are mutually perpendicular to each other. The thumb represents force on the conductor. The forefinger represents the direction of the magnetic field. The middle finger gives the direction of the current. How we can easily memorize this? Thumb, forefinger, middle finger. The father, mother, child. The father means force on a conductor. The mother means magnetic field. The child means current. That means the thumb gives the direction of the force. The forefinger gives the direction of the magnetic field. The middle finger gives the direction of the current. So you can easily store in your memory father, mother, child. Father means force on a conductor, mother means magnetic field, child means current. Look at this diagram. Here I took the magnet north and south. So the magnetic field direction is always north to south. And the conductor is placed between the magnetic field. And the current is flowing through a conductor. We have learned that when the current is flowing in the conductor, it produces a magnetic field around it. And we have the external magnetic field also. These two magnetic field or exert equal and opposite forces to each other. Due to that force, the conductor get displaced. In what direction the conductor will be displaced? So you have to find the direction of the force on the conductor. You have to take your left hand and keep your left hand in this way. Don't keep in this way. You know that the forefinger represent the magnetic field direction. Here the magnetic field is north to south. So the forefinger represent the magnetic field direction. And the current is up to down. So the middle finger gives the direction of the current. And when we kept the forefinger and middle finger here, the thumb finger is in upward direction. So the force on the current carrying conductor moves in the upward direction. Because this is a force, this is magnetic field, and this is current. Do you understand how to find the force on the current carrying conductor? You have to take your left hand and stretch your thumb finger, forefinger and middle finger. They are mutually perpendicular to each other. The forefinger gives the magnetic field direction. The middle finger gives the direction of current. And the thumb finger gives the force on the conductor. You have to find the direction of your force on the conductor for this. Here see, the two magnets are kept. So the magnetic field direction is north to south. The current direction is upward. You have to find the direction of force on the conductor. What you do? You have to take your left hand and keep in this way. See, this is a magnetic field direction because here north pole to south pole is a magnetic field. And the current is down to up. So this gives the current direction. And see the thumb finger, it is a downward. So the force on the current carrying conductor is in downward direction. Do you understand how to find the direction of force on the conductor? So what are the application of this force on a current carrying conductor in magnetic field? Device that use current carrying conductors and magnetic field include electric motor, electric generator, loudspeakers, microphones, measuring instrument. So the application of force on a current carrying conductor is it is used in electric motor, electric generator, loudspeaker, microphone and measuring instrument. The next class we will see about the electric motor, how the force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field is used in electric motors and generators. Homework. What do you learned from this activity? Where do you use Fleming's left hand rule? You have to answer for these two questions. Take your book and see chapter number 13, Magnetic Effects of Electric Current. And see the topic, today's topic. Force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. And see the activity. This is aluminium rod and horseshoe magnet. The aluminium rod are connected in the series with the battery, key and also rheostat. And see here, this is a very important sentence. The direction of force on the conductor depends upon the direction of the current and the direction of the magnetic field. What is the meaning of this? When we change the direction of the current, the direction of the force on the conductor also changed. When we change the direction of the magnetic field, the direction of the force on the conductor also changed. And when the magnetic field and the current are perpendicular to each other, the force on the conductor is maximum, that is a right angle. When the magnetic field direction, when the magnetic field and the current is mutually perpendicular and it makes a right angle, that means 90 degree with each other, the force on the conductor is maximum. And this is the Fleming left hand rule. Using the Fleming left hand rule, we can find the direction of the motion of the conductor. For in a left hand, thumb and forefinger and middle finger stretch mutually perpendicular to each other. The thumb finger represent the direction or force on the conductor, and forefinger gives the direction of the magnetic field. And middle finger gives the direction of the current. And where we are using the force on the current carrying conductor in a magnetic field, we are using this application in electric motor, electric generator, loudspeakers, microphones and measuring instrument. The next class, we will see the topic in 13.4, electric motor. And see the book exercise question number 9. When the force experienced by a current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field largest. So when the force experienced by a current carrying conductor is large, when the magnetic field and the current direction is makes a right angle, then the force experienced by a current carrying conductor is maximum. And see the question number 15. State the rule to determine the direction of magnetic field produced around a straight current carrying conductor. So how to find For in a first question answer, using the right hand thumb rule, we can find the magnetic field direction around a straight conductor. In second question C, force experienced by a current carrying straight conductor placed in a magnetic field which is perpendicular to it. So which rule is used to find the force experienced by a conductor? Using Fleming left hand rule, we can find the force on the conductor. You have to answer the 15th question in second, and also you have to answer the 9th question. Thank you for watching. If you have any doubt in this topic, you can ask through the teachment. Thank you.